In this problem, we have a reaction vessel that we start out with 50 moles of B at 100 degrees C, and then we add the reactant A, which is at 25 degrees C, and we're adding it at a rate of 10 moles per hour. The reaction is A goes to B, so we're starting out reactor containing product B, and we want to carry out the reaction at 100 degrees C. And so the question is, what's the rate of heat transfer required to maintain the reactor at 100 degrees C? So it's going to be a function of time, because as reaction rate changes, the heat transfer rate changes. We're given heat capacities and heat of reaction, and we're told the reaction is first order. So the first thing we want to do is draw a diagram that represents this system. So here, capital N represents the number of moles, and capital F represents a molar flow rate. So first thing we want to do is a mole balance on the reactant A. And that says the change in the number of moles of A in the reactor respect to time is due to the fact we're adding A, so we have a molar flow rate in, and then we're reacting A. So rate of reaction per volume times the volume. So this is FA0 minus, since it's first order, KCA times V. It turns out to be convenient. In this case, CA times V is the number of moles of A. So we have an equation that's just in the number of moles of A and time, which means we can separate variables and integrate this analytically. So change in number of moles, FA0 minus KNA is equal to DT. So we integrate from 0 to some time. We integrate from 0, because initially there are no moles of A in the reactor, into number of moles of A at time T. So if we integrate this, the left side, we have minus 1 over K times the log FA0 minus K times NA, and evaluated between the two limits. The right side is just T. So the limits, FA0 minus K NA over FA0, and that's equal to minus K times T. Now what I want to solve for is K times NA, because that term, the rate of reaction is going to appear in the energy balance, and we need the energy balance to determine the rate of heat transfer. So I'm going to take the exponential of both sides of this equation, and that gives me, and this is 1 minus K NA over FA0, and then I can rearrange this for solve for K and A. I'm now going to use this K and A value in the energy balance. So now we're going to write the energy balance. First thing we should note is that derivative of temperature respect to time is going to be 0. We want to keep this 100 degrees C. So the energy balance is termed due to the fact we're flowing in A at 25 degrees C, and we need to heat that to 100 degrees C. And then we're generating heat from the heat reaction, rate reaction times volume, and then removing heat through heat transfer. Keep in mind R sub A times V, this term, minus KCA times V is equal to minus K times NA, and that's what we calculated from our mass balance. So now we can substitute in numerical values. So I've substituted in for the first term. The second term, I put the heat of reaction in joules per mole. So R sub A times V is minus K times NA, and so that's minus FA0, which is 10 moles per hour times 1 minus e to the minus 1.8 times time. And then the last term, q dot, which is what we're solving for. So here's the final heat transfer rate, and it's a function of time. As reaction proceeds, we're going to have to remove less heat from the system.